Hello and welcome to the Monday, November 23rd, 2020 edition of the Sands and Its Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Here in the United States, this week, of course, is Thanksgiving week with that no podcast on Thursday and Friday and likely shorter podcast the other days because it tends to be sort of a little bit slow news week. And Thanksgiving 2000, so about 20 years ago, was actually the weekend where I wrote the first version of The Shield and made it live the week after. So to celebrate this, we'll do another Raspberry Pi giveaway this week. What you'll have to do is go to the show notes page and there is a link to a quick survey. Two questions, and the third question is then your email address. So if you would like to participate in the giveaway, just leave your email address. And well, in security news, we have a VMware update to start out with. It fixes a critical vulnerability in VMware ESXi and Workstation, as well as Fusion. This is a privilege escalation vulnerability that would essentially allow an administrator of a virtual machine to run code on the host. The vulnerable component here is the XHCI USB controller. So for the ESXi folks who may have a harder time upgrading than some of the Workstation products, you have the option to just disable this USB controller, which is probably not often really used. And if you're one of the few organizations running IBM's DB2 database, there is an update for you that fixes, first of all, DLL hijacking vulnerability, and then also a buffer overflow vulnerability that could be used by a local attacker to execute code with root privileges. So it doesn't appear to be exploitable across the network, but that second vulnerability is probably the one that you really should pay attention to. And a Twitter user using the name Bank Security posted that they found on a hacker forum a list of 49,000 IP addresses that are vulnerable to the Fortinet SSL VPN exploit. That's CVE-2018-13379, and credentials associated with those IP addresses. So this is an older vulnerability, and this year, of course, we talked multiple times about how important it is to make sure that your perimeter security and VPN devices are up to date. And if you find yourself on one of those lists, of course, expect that couple different bad guys already sort of fought their way into your system, and they may actually have it secured now. So don't be lulled into a false sense of security by thinking that it's patched and as a result not compromised. Well, and that's it for today. Like I said, I want to keep it a little bit shorter this week. So thanks for listening. And don't forget, you'll find a link to the three-question survey in the show notes. Thanks, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.